my Varyawala was a pioneer in more than just one sense of the word. Not only was she India's first female photojournalist, but her career documented the overthrow of the British colonial rule. Humai Varyawala was born on 9 December 1913 to a Parsi Zoroastrian family in Navsari, Gujarat. Varyawala spent her childhood moving from place to place with her father's travelling theatre company. After moving to Bombay, Humai Varyawala studied at Bombay University and the Sir J.J. School of Art. Humai recalled, "As a child, I once saw a photograph of another child lying on its stomach. I was told that it was taken by a woman and wondered if I would ever get a chance like that. She certainly did, for by the late 1930s, she had moved to Delhi and embarked upon what would be a 30-year career in photojournalism." Varyawala started her career in 1930s, at the onset of World War II. She started working on assignments for Mumbai-based The Illustrated Weekly of India magazine, which published many of her most admired black and white images. In the early years of her career, since Varyawala was unknown and a woman, her photographs were published under her husband's name. Varyawala stated that because women were not taken seriously as journalists, she was able to take high-quality, revealing photographs of her subject without interference. People were rather orthodox. They didn't want the women folk to be moving around all over the place, and when they saw me in a sari with a camera hanging around, they thought it was a very strange sight. And in the beginning, they thought I was just fooling around with the camera, just showing off or something, and they didn't take me seriously. But that was to my advantage because I could go to the sensitive areas and also to take pictures and nobody will stop me. So I was able to take the best of the pictures and to get them published. It was only when the pictures got published that people realized how seriously I was working for the place. Eventually, her photography received notice at the national level, particularly after moving to Delhi in 1942 to join the British Information Service. As a press photographer, she recorded many political and national leaders in the period leading up to independence, including Mahatma Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru, her favorite, Muhammad Ali Jinnah, Indira Gandhi, and the Nehru-Gandhi family. In 1956, she photographed for Life magazine the 14th Dalai Lama when he entered Sikkim in India for the first time via the Nathula. Most of her photographs were published under the pseudonym Dada 13. The reason behind her choice of this name were that her birth year was 1913. She met her husband at the age of 13 and her first caste number plate read DLD 13. In 1970, shortly after her husband's death, Humi Varyawala decided to give up photography, laminating bad behavior of the new generation of photographers. She did not take a single photograph in the last 40 plus years of her life. When asked why she quit photography while at the peak of her profession, she said, "It was not worth it anymore. We had rules for photographers. We followed a dress code. We treated each other with respect, like colleagues. But then things changed for the worse. They were only interested in making a few quick bucks. I didn't want to be part of a crowd anymore." Later in life, Varyawala gave her collection of photographs to Delhi-based Alkais Foundation for Arts. And in 2020, in collaboration with National Gallery of Modern Art, Mumbai, the foundation presented a retrospective of her work. These online exhibitions featured poignant descriptions, including one recounting how Humai decided last minute not to attend Gandhi's prayer meeting at Birla House on 30th January 1948. Mahatma Gandhi would be assassinated at this meeting with no photographers present. According to Gadioke, Humai would regret her decision not to attend for the rest of her life. In a longer article on the foundation's website, Gadioke points out that Humai's work has often been sidelined in favor of work by Western photographers. In 1998, she was honored with Chameli Devi Jain Award for Outstanding Women Media Person. Google honored Varyawala on the 104th birth anniversary of hers, First Lady of Lenses. She was awarded Padma Vibhushan. India's second highest civilian honor in 2011. Varyawala was married to Manikshaw Jamshedji Varyawala, an accountant and photographer for the Times of India. In 1970, a year after her husband's death, she gave up photography as she did not wish to work with new generation paparazzi culture. Humi Varyawala then moved to Pilani, Rajasthan with her only son Farooq, who taught at BIT as Pilani. She returned to Vadodara with her son in 1982. After her son's death from cancer in 1989, she lived alone in a small apartment in Baroda and spent her time gardening. In January 2012, Variawala fell from her bed and fractured a hip bone. Her neighbors helped her reach a hospital where she developed breathing complications. She had been suffering from intestinal lung disease, which resulted in her death on 15 January 2012. Homi Variawala was the only professional women photojournalist in India during her time, and her survival in a male-dominated field is all the more significant because the profession continues to exclude most women even today. Ironically, Western photojournalists who visited India, such as Henry Cartier-Bresson and Margaret Brooke White, have received more attention than their Indian contemporaries. In an already invisible history, Homi Variawala's presence as a woman was even more marginalized. As Alka's Foundation's Gadioke reminds us, it is time that we re-enter Homi's work in the history of Indian independence.